The Minister of Energy and Mineral Development tabled the Petroleum Supplies Amendment Bill 2023 before Parliament on Tuesday, October 31st, seeking to end reliance on Kenya for its petroleum imports and have the mandate taken over by the Ugandan National Oil Company. However, this has sparked off a battle between energy and logistics companies. Two companies that include Maersk Line Limited and E3 Energy appeared before Parliament's Committee on Natural Resources to oppose the move of having such a juicy contract handed over to Vitol, calling on Parliament to open the market for other players.
Even if it is a single supply oligopoly, the element of monopoly is eliminated by many refineries competing against each other. And UNOC has better capacity about oil negotiations than even all of us. So now it's up to UNOC to negotiate with the refineries, because if you can look.
Leading the appearance before the committee was Rogers Mogambwa, the technical advisor, Trade Finance Maersk Limited, who informed the committee that Maersk Line Limited is ready, willing, and able to support Ugandan National Oil Company to sign a supply agreement.
Finance structure, the step one, our country representative, WEC International Limited, on behalf of Maersk Line, offers a proposal for establishment of a bank guarantee or standby letter of credit to the refinery.
As a logistics company, we've had issues of how do you access the Kenya pipeline system. Would that be up to Maersk to sort out, and Uganda, we just wait for our product at the point at Mahathi and Jinja? We don't have to get, Uganda has no business getting involved in Kenya and any of those logistical issues.
E3 Energy Group, in its presentation before the committee, established itself as a reliable, reputable, efficient, and competitive supplier in this regional market.
We also support many of the local oil companies with product, including some of the majors like Vivo Energy and Stepex.
We have in Uganda, how come you're not even made a suggestion? You just make a proposal. How then you say business sense, making a proposal to UNOC that this was making sense. I joined him in wondering why you never made this proposal at all to UNOC that you could make such business with us.
Fuel suppliers listed a cocktail of benefits Uganda would reap if the contract is handed to them, including employment opportunities for Ugandans, turn Uganda into a trading hub for neighboring export markets, among others.
Of establishing yourself as a major trading hub to supply to DRC market through Uganda under this arrangement, if UNOC or the government is willing to do that and they are ready to tap these opportunities and generate export revenues for the country, whether it is for Congo or South Sudan or Rwanda.
If you can see even the sample we did yesterday, just our principals calling any of the refineries, and we did the computation, the price of diesel here after all taxes and profit of wholesale and retail margin profit of 400 shillings, and it is still 3,900.
Our worry is, like the way Chair mentioned it, we hope, or rather, will you be ready to continue supplying as you wait? Because our worry will come in when you say, our agreement says this date, until we get this money, that's when we shall add you more fuel.
However, as more companies seek to be considered in the deal, government has already signed an agreement with Vitol as a sole supplier of fuel to the Ugandan National Oil Company. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.